Hey guys, you're Worker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool career mode. Where the I'm left off. He continued on the start of season 3 of the career mode. And in this episode, continuing on again. In this episode, I hope to get in 2 games, but in between this game, the Leicester game, and the next game, which is going to be Newcastle, in between then is a long period, including the summer window, ending. So hopefully that won't slow me down. And I have no targets. I'm not making any signings. I have no intention of letting anyone go. Oh, unless it's on a loan, or if I get a really good offer for a player that I could do without, like someone like Brannigan, then yeah. But hopefully I can get not only this game against Leicester to King Owl, but also the game against Newcastle as well.
His four.
Well, it's good to see them going with two games today. Anyway,
Royce.
Hopefully, I have. I don't know if I can provide you guys with a 4-5 classic. Like, I have no intention of conceding 4 goals at any point in any career mode. So, if you guys want to see E5 goals from me without reply, I can do that. But, yeah, that shit was crazy with
and the result
Liverpool and Norwich. The match was crazy. It was breathtaking. Klopp lost his glasses. Everyone went fucking mental.
Jordan Henderson.
Norwich. Liverpool learned that someone in the Premier League is actually just as bad as defending as us. And it's Norwich. So Norwich, they might want to look into that, because being worse than Liverpool at defending is not exactly how you stay up. I wouldn't imagine that's how he would stay up in the Premier League.
Push him out there, and he just runs and runs till the final whistle. Jota,
and there it is for Liverpool. And oh, that is a fantastic goal by Neymar. Blasts in, doesn't give Schmeichel any sort of chance whatsoever.
An awful long way out. Superb.
Bang. A rocket. Oh, a shot. And a nice goal. Will they go with it?
Liverpool have taken the lead.
But yeah, like I was saying, the Liverpool Norwich game was pretty crazy. There was BS. There was I was pissed off. I was close to getting on a plane to go in Liverpool to absolutely rip Moreno's head off. What the fuck was he doing for that penalty? Can somebody explain it to me in a way that it would actually make sense, because I don't think there is a way that you can justify that. And it makes, that it would make sense why he did that. Because I don't think he was thinking.
It's a real tussle between the two.
No, I don't think he was thinking. I think he was 100% just being an absolute fucking
Neymar
shit for brains. And, I wouldn't play him for the rest of the season. I really wouldn't. Especially not when we have John Flanagan back from injury now, after his long injury. I would play him. Or sign a new left back. God forbid. That we get decent defensive players. That might actually provide us with a... Or play Brad Smith. He's been pretty good in the cup competitions when we've played him.
Very well done. with the inside of the head.
So, well, it's an option.
To take the corner, a goal to the good, of course.
It makes me disappointed because I just wonder, would Moreno even be playing right now had Gomez never gotten injured? Because I don't think he would be, you know? And another fantastic goal. Well, Leicester don't seem to be interested in defending themselves today. This is the second long ranger that they've let go in.
Angle on it here.
And this time for Varane. A top quality striker. He's a center back. Pretty good goal for a center back.
Just widen the.
I think that would be better than Bessong's. Bessong's goal was good as well. I'm not gonna take anything away from that goal. It was a very good goal for a center back.
Conte. He's read that well in midfield to get them on the ball.
Or any defender, Okazaki. Really. I mean, when you're a defender, you take any chance you get to score. Or it's a tap in, or it's a really good goal like Bessong. Of Reigns,
Neymar,
you will take it. I mean, defenders don't get as much chances as their midfielders and strikers do to score their top quality goals, especially in high quality league like the Premier League.
Good work by the goalkeeper.
And there is halftime.
And 2-0 is the score at the halfway mark. I think that's a good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in the first half?
I would be happy with that.
Talking about Varane's goal. Let's see. Other teams I should be interested in. Chelsea are probably the only one right about now. And they are winning against Villa. But I am winning 2-0, so
it's
have that on them.
Game to win, really. Now they've got the lead at half time.
Correa going to score straight half. From the kickoff? Yes, he is.
That's in the back of the net, and it's there for Liverpool.
Correa bags him of another goal.
Today, real philosophy with that one into the bottom right.
7 already in the league.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
Sorry about that. Just trying to get the dog to shut up. Seriously. I don't know what it takes to keep my dog quiet. He likes to bark whenever I'm doing my videos.
Neymar.
I don't know if you guys can hear him.
Well, he's totally dictating the tempo.
Never mind.
He's a great asset for his team.
Him watching the video back, I never hear him, but some of you guys might be able to hear him. I don't know, maybe I'm not listening carefully enough. I'm focusing more on how well the commentary was, you know, because sometimes I can go off topic, sometimes I can like stutter or
speculation. Eden Hazard has moved to
go quiet completely. And
I knew who they wanted, and
I do realize I'm doing that. You guys are probably the reason. And anytime I do get a comment, it's like, what's going on with the commentary? What's wrong with the commentary? I don't know why I do that. I think it's because I'm not really used to. I'm not much of a talker normally. I'm one of those people who, you saw me, you wouldn't even know I was in the room. Seriously, I'm that quiet. I'm that.
No doubt about
I'm a
that.
Quiet person most of the time. I'm passionate Oh, a goal. They've got one fucking up because that was stupid defending. What was I fucking thinking?
With accuracy from distance.
Wasn't even chat shit get banged.
Scoreline as we restart the game. Let's look at it again.
As I was saying, I'm passionate about playing games, and you know, I like watching other people on YouTube, so I thought, you know, I'll do it as a hobby and see.
Maybe he made his run a bit too soon.
If I could do it, I don't really expect anything to come from
Marco Royce. Here's a chance to move forward.
Subscribers just pop in,
interception.
Subscribe and like the video and leave thousands of comments.
Get away here.
Apparently, if you get lots of views and you don't get comments, it's fishy. So, fuck you, guy who left that comment. I'm glad I blocked you. You mad? Yeah, I definitely think you are definitely mad. Too bad, so sad. I blocked him because he has smart mouths. And I don't like people with smart mouths. I'm the only one who's allowed to have a smart mouth around here.
Coming up for you, of course, on EA Sports, the presentation of the Barclays Premier League fixture. This could be it. Well, we will count that as a shot, but it was a very poor one and a long, long way wide from a long, 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 long way out.
I'm sure his manager might have a little quiet word afterwards about that decision.
He's cut out the pass, intercepting if you like, and now can go on the attack maybe. Leicester looking to get the ball up the other end of the field quickly. Shot on! And the goalkeeper with a text.
Are you freaking serious? Did I seriously hit the opposition's striker?
Liverpool with
Leicester striker.
Here, and they've deserved it.
Damn it.
Conte. It's Leicester City who are going to make the substitution.
Klein.
Nathaniel Klein got on the ball in midfield.
No, straight at Kante. Brilliant.
Player in that part of the pitch.
Fucking
Lawrence.
Stupid ass. No.
Well beaten this side.
Thank you, Leicester, for having strikers to absolutely suck. Oh, now they bring on Jamie Vardy. Just as I said. Hey, thanks for having on your strikers who absolutely suck. They bring on their best one. And that was fantastic, Ricardo. Get that shit out here.
Still on the attack, and they've got a corner. Liverpool's
there is no time for.
It's not the biggest ground in world football, but it's certainly got an atmosphere with the on them.
Catch it! It, goalkeeper, for fuck's sake.
Walk down those steps. Underneath the famous
something I expect out of Mignolet, for fuck's sake. Catch it. Thank you. Don't trip over Vardy.
Straightforward for goalkeepers, but
get it out.
He's not been challenged.
Foul. Or full time, I'll take that too. Disappointed I conceded a goal, but it was my own fault. I'll take 4-1. Chelsea 1, United dropped 2 points. Way! They were already 2 points behind me, now they're even further behind. Dumbasses. Let's see, who am I training now? Merlis, he is almost to 61, so let's get him up. Let's go for some of the lower rated players for a bit. See if I can't get them to a decent rating. Like Clips. Oops. No, stop. Add drill. Let's see. Neymar is about to go up to a 90 rated player. probably go up in the next game or his next great performance, which will probably be the next game, to be honest. Or who knows, maybe he'll go up on the after the goal in the game against Leicester. Brandon just jumped up a hell of a lot. He's a bit closer to 70, 68. Maybe someone will look at him now. I was just about to say Matchev, that's an offer for him. Nope, it's Divock Origi. Not interested in selling Divock Origi. Just going to disallow future offers so I don't get any more for him. Come on, let's get through this window. Like I said, I have no transfers to make. Let's keep an eye on the ins and outs. Kabul is con. Dermich has gone to Werder Bremen. Oh, wow. Everton fucking signing Lacazette. Go fuck yourselves, Everton. This is not going to make any difference. You know I'm still way better than you. Ooh. Wow, they're all the other Premier League teams are making big signings. Aston Villa, some guy named Corona for 29 million. Bournemouth signing a 30-year-old left mid for 19 million. Up there's Chelsea and Aston, and now sorry, West Ham. West Ham signing, I think he's a centre back. Yeah, a centre back, 22 million. Fournier just came into a nice bit of money. There's Leicester making a new signing. Well, luckily I just played them, so it's no concern of mine. West Brom signing Victor Wanyama. Marlos has gone to Stoke. I'm pretty sure everyone has done something big. A lot of the teams have done something big already. Which is, yeah, that's a bit of a piss take. 378 million. Are we gonna, is there any last minute deals? I saw Brighton went up to 68 on his own. And Chan asked me after the end of the window, can I sell him? You're brilliant, Emery. You really are. Yeah, you deserve a medal for that one. Dumbass. Come on. We don't have all day. I don't care about being Wales manager. I have Bale. Who else on the Welsh team would I want to manage? Maybe Aaron Ramsey, but you know, if I really wanted Ramsey, I could bring him in. You want to play, do you, Tillemans? I can arrange that. Neymar did go up to 90. Coutinho is 88 rated. Damn. Everyone is just freaking growing like crazy. Coming up against Danny Ings for the first time since his transfer away. Should be interesting. Okay. Why am I doing this?
Well, we've got Barclays Premier League.
Right, the goal.
I'm Martin Tyler, and
first and foremost, goal is to win, but I do want to get a clean sheet to make up for that.
This was the
calamity against Leicester.
2013-14 Premier League season for both these clubs, wasn't it? And Newcastle actually went in front at Anfield. Liverpool got the win, but they didn't get the title, Alan.
Start out with a nice wide ball. Or Royce whips it into the newly 88 rated Coutinho, who misses it completely. Brilliant.
This is the Liverpool side.
Brilliant.
Rafael Varane in central defence. Marco Royce starts looking to continue his great form in midfield.
The guys know Ings well.
Newcastle United, two changes for them.
Surprise.
Tim Krul starts in goal.
Against Danny Ings, I know how to handle him.
Who's shown poor form lately.
It's something wrong. I know how to defend against
clear the danger.
Because I know using him in my second team.
Newspaper inches devoted to
the past two seasons.
Manager and the
very successfully
of an international job, but we understand that he's turned that down.
Yeah, well, maybe he's got other irons in the fire. Only he can tell you that. He doesn't see it as the job for him quite clearly.
Foul.
The referee giving the player the benefit of the doubt about that, but he's given the free kick.
Going Rolando Irons. I don't know what that kid was expecting.
That's
what I was expecting. And another goal from Correa, number 8 of the season. Buries it in
the top of the keeper before he could
in the back of the net.
And here is another angle on that goal.
Mbemba tried to get in the way, but he didn't succeed. 1-0.
So the first goal, it's
1-0. So, first goal of winning this match. We're on our way to that. Clean sheets are still looking good, because Newcastle haven't even been in my box, let alone near my goal.
Strong, fair challenge, pulls out for a throw, though. Rafael Varane. In here. Sometimes, certainly in days gone by, an away draw was seen as a good result. I think most teams go to try and win the matches. They've drawn their last three, the visiting team today.
I'm not really paying attention to anywhere other than top four at the moment, so I don't know where in the table Newcastle are. So.
Bale.
Personally, hope they're doing well against
them. He has
them.
Been pressed there to running the ball out of play.
Newcastle. Coutinho.
Opportunity now.
Philippe.
Oh, that's great defending.
Good block.
Great passage of.
Let's come back to Coutinho. Neymar.
Neymar. Super goal.
And he celebrates becoming 90 rated with a nice cheeky goal.
Goal from Neymar. And he
sure, at this point, he'd probably be starting to win Player of the Year, wouldn't he? Because this is three seasons from now. His fourth goal of the season.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
He's someone I would expect to at least be among the candidates for top goal scorer come the end of the season. Him, Coutinho would probably have to be up there after winning it last year. And of course, Correa is the current top goal scorer.
Well, going into this game for the home side.
And again, my team is full of goals. Also, every outfield player having at least scored
out on the pitch there.
One even more.
Full extension, the goalkeeper makes the save. So they can regroup now at a goal kick.
Everyone has
another view now.
Has about three or four goals at least, and that includes all my defenders. First, especially Varane, who's the only
Royce.
One who scored yet this season. Wait, hang on. No, I retract that, because Rodriguez scored in the first game, didn't he?
Here's the shot over the goalkeeper, but over the bar as well, just. Not a good challenge by the defender. From Gareth Bale, they put that far too close to the goalkeeper.
So I'm gonna go into the halftime break 2-0 up. Something happens in the last, in the dying moments of the first half. For this up the pitch, they've been all okay so far, and it hasn't come to anything except the ball safely into the hands of my goalkeeper. I say safely after what he did in the last... Well, it was my fault, really. No way I can blame him for something I did. That wouldn't be fair.
And the referee blows. He started the second half here at Anfield.
Wow, thank you. They've gifted Neymar the ball, and he scored. You do not give Neymar the ball. He has to... win it from you. That's how he earns his goal. You can't just gift wrap it and say, here you go, that's a nice... It's an early Christmas present. And I don't know what name
it is. A slightly different viewpoint on it.
Fifth goal in the league.
One team really on their game today. The other very off colour.
Before you know it, he'll catch Correa. I mean, eight goals may seem insurmountable, but that's only three more than Neymar. And if Newcastle keep making gift wrapping goals for Neymar, he's going to catch them pretty goddamn quickly.
To throw the ball to one of your teammates.
While he's only scored one so far, I wouldn't rule out Coutinho or even Royce or even Bale over there on the other side.
Everton,
like I said, my team
completed that
full
transfer, Alan.
Of goals. You never know who could win. Top goal scorer. Oh, even though my bench is full of goals. Of course, Divock Origi was top goal scorer in the first season.
Marco Royce,
having only played like half of it. First half, he spent on the bench, but when he came in for Correa, he became the top goal scorer because he scored in just about every single game.
Now he's looking for support. Well, he's beaten his man. And he's lost control. Vernon Anita. On it. The referee's given the free kick. Goalkeeper will get this one, no problem.
Hands now, clear it. Coutinho. I direct the ball away from him. And with a decent tackle. But when all of them under pressure, he didn't make a mistake. Ooh, and that he almost did
right
though.
The touchline, it's put the ball out for a throw.
Although he won a
Chancel Mbemba.
He won the throw in, so
Marco Royce.
Not really a mistake when you win a throw in or something off of your opponent. Generally you win a foul if that's the case. But obviously the war is being won by me. It's 3-0.
Mbemba.
No matter how many battles Newcastle win.
Ease the pressure.
Going on scoreline tells all, and scoreline tells me it's 3-0.
Ricardo Rodriguez.
Royce.
He's still going. Fine run this. And the cross is in.
Neymar completes his hat trick.
It's a hat trick.
Yes. No.
He's really been on form.
Yeah, he did.
Well, Alan, maybe that's the one he'll treasure the most because it's given him the hat trick.
Yeah.
Just like that, he's doubled his match ball with a tally for the season in one game.
A comfortable game, this 4-0.
Now he's only 2 goals behind Correa. He'd only be 1 behind if Correa hadn't scored that at the opener. So,
it's a goal for
Correa. Wanna make sure he's not too comfortable in first place. He's not just yet, anyway.
4-0 here, and almost time up. What does this mean for their next game?
Well, Newcastle United go up against Manchester United.
The person who's allowed to be comfortable in first place is me, being in first place in the league, because no one can challenge me. Seriously, if Chelsea are going to try and be my competition again this season, they want to put up a better fight than they did last season, because they dropped a lot of clumsy points, which led to a very early title win for me.
And he claims the cross.
It didn't help that I won every single game, but, you know, they could have won some games and, you know, at least made a goddamn competition out of it. Seriously. It's no fun if he do all my work for me. And they took things off. Why? Why not just... Yeah, why did you brought that guy on to just see out the last couple of seconds. And that is a
they never let up,
star quality management there from Steve McLaren or whoever the hell the Newcastle manager is at this point in the game. I don't know if it's Steve McLaren. I'd be surprised if it were, because if he lasts till the end of the season, I would be shocked. And I think Newcastle fans would be both shocked and a bit pissed off because they don't really like him. Chelsea were not playing today. Brilliant. So, I gained 3 points on them anyway. Or were they? Super Dilly Man's in form. I like that. That sounds like a superhero name or some shit. Super Dilly Man's! Oh, in the next episode, I begin my Champions League campaign once again. Looking to retain that historic trophy. No one went up, because of course not, because training is... it's an optional thing. And of course, wouldn't you know it, they put me up against 2 former clubs in Sporting... and Inter Milan, who I both managed in last year's game. So, yeah, start top quality draw there, EA. Yeah, didn't really want to face teams I had no past with. Like, Anderlecht, I'm good. Ooh, Chelsea! Oh, the next episode just got very interesting. Sporting and Chelsea. Do not miss the next episode, because I'm already gonna beat my closest rivals. So, next episode may as well be for the title. So yeah, don't miss it. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Hit subscribe for more videos. And until next time, I hope you all have a very...